I grew up in this little town, Fernandina Beach. Started out in a family of net makers. My name's Johnny Burbank, and I'm down here at the docks where my life pretty much started out. Learned a net making skill and learned how to provide for my family. Learned how to work hard, but one thing I also learned down here at the docks and at the net shop was how to drink and how to consume alcohol, and it became a way of life also. And as I grew and progressed, trying to write the story of my life, the alcohol grew along with me. Our motto, work like a man, drink like a man. After I got married and had children of my own, alcohol started becoming a problem in my life. And my wife, trying to help me, she brought me up to the steps of her church that she was raised up in, First Baptist Church. And that was the hardest thing I'd ever done in my life, because I figured that people in there were gonna judge me and probably take me out back and stone me. They welcomed me in, about loved me to death. And I tried to get my life on track. But every time I fell on my face, relapsed, I'd crawl back up those steps. They'd welcome me back in and love me unconditionally. I found myself in a long-term rehab up in Georgia. I hadn't slept in 3 nights, and about 3 o'clock in the morning, I found myself out underneath the pine trees and looking up at the stars and crying out to God. And I was pretty much telling God, you know, how he messed up and was blaming him for everything, where I'd ended up and everything in my life. And he said 3 words. He said, "I want you." And I knew then what he wanted. There was many times when Jesus would dig a grave for me, and he'd lead me to that grave. And I would get to it, and I would think about getting in it and dying to self. But in the end, I would circle that grave, and I'd end up walking off. He called me to that grave this particular night, 3 o'clock in the morning, and I knew then. And I crawled in, died to self, my old life, buried. He resurrected me in him through the power of the Holy Spirit, and my life ain't never been the same. After coming home, he opened the door for me, a ministry at the Nassau County Jail. And I carried a meeting out there for 16 years every Tuesday night, sharing the gospel with young men and older men in the jail that were trying to find a new life. And I was able to carry the gospel in there and share with them. And God discipled not only them, he discipled me through it all. It's just a blessing for me to be able to serve at First Baptist Church. They call them my tribe. They prayed for me, and I get to go in and worship with them, get to learn with them. It's like the word says, he restores what the locusts have taken away. And he did that in my life. He restored me. I'm now, you know, in a business with 2 Christian men that I love dearly, and we have a business that I can only dream about. And it's all because of God and what he's done in my life. And the relationship with my wife and my children now is just everything that I ever wanted. All my dreams that looked like were gone and shattered, he restored them, and he did it in a way that I could have never dreamed of and could have never done on my own.